Now, listen to verse 15. But not as the offense, so also is the free gift. For it, through the offense of one, many be dead. Now listen to this. Much more. You get much more in Christ. Much more the grace of God and the gift by grace, which is by one man, Jesus Christ, hath abounded unto men. Now he's presenting here. You see the headship of Christ. We have much more in Christ, and we today are looking forward to something more wonderful than the Garden of Eden. We're told in Hebrews 11:13, these all died in faith, not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off, were persuaded of them and embraced them and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims in the earth. What a wonderful thing. Verse 16, and not as it was by one that sinned, so is the gift. For the judgment was by one to condemnation, but the free gift is of many offenses unto justification. Now, I recognize this is a difficult passage of Scripture. This is one of those very difficult passages. Now, all this section simply means this. One transgression plunged the race into sin. One act of obedience and the death of Christ upon the cross makes it possible for lost man to be saved. And he presents to us, therefore, actually here, two kingdoms. And in verse 18, I read, therefore, as by the offense of one, judgment came upon all men to condemnation. Even so, by the righteousness of one, the free gift came upon all men unto justification of life. Now, verse 19, for as by one man's disobedience many were made sinners, so by the obedience of one shall many be made righteous. These are the two kingdoms that are presented to us. There is the kingdom of death. That's Adam's. We belong to that. In Adam all die. Then there is that one of life, the Lamb's Book of Life. Are you written in it? And these are the two kingdoms. Death reigns over one, Christ over the other. He is the one that gives life today. Notice verse 20. Moreover, the law entered, that the offense might abound, but where sin abounded, grace did much more abound. And you notice, when God gave the law, he gave with it a sacrificial system. And then later on, Christ came to fulfill that part of it too. In other words, God has given to the human race, a lost race, an opportunity to be delivered from the guilt of sins, and not the nature of sin. Now you and I will have that until we die. Now, will you notice that we come to the last verse of this very difficult section, verse 21. That as sin hath reigned unto death. You see, you and I are living in a world today where sin reigns. You want to know who's the king of the earth today? Satan is the prince. He's the one that goes up and down the earth seeking whom he may devour. That's Peter 5:8. Sin hath reigned unto death, and the cemeteries are still being filled because of that. Now he says, even so might grace reign through righteousness unto eternal life by Jesus Christ our Lord. And he's calling out a people today out of a lost race, and he's teaching turtles to fly if they want to. That's no reflection on the turtles that don't want to, because it's their nature. They're alienated. Man is alienated from God, and that's our nature. Now, God offers salvation to a lost race. This is the tremendous subject of imputation of sin, and it's actually potential sanctification. It's on this foundation that God now will seek not only to save man from the guilt of sin, but to make mankind that trusts him free, to deliver them that they can live from God.